When it comes to CO2, I often get the question about passive diffusion and what a CO2 bell is because I use some of it in my tanks. In this video, we're going to talk about passive diffusion and about the CO2 bell. Welcome to another video, and this is Chung from The Water Box. And if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button and hit the like button if you like this video. First of all, let's get down to it and let's talk about passive CO2. A lot of people have asked me about this question about what is that sitting in your tank and why do you fill it with CO2? Does passive CO2 work? Does it not work? Does it work better than pressurized CO2, or does it work with no CO2, or work better with no CO2? So we're going to tackle that question right now. Okay, so first of all, let's talk about just CO2 in our atmosphere. Now, most of our atmosphere is composed of nitrogen, about 78%, and then oxygen, which is about, I think, 21%. The rest is like 1% of other gases. And within that other gases is CO2. Now, when we don't have any CO2 being fed into our tanks, we just let it naturally happen. CO2 gets exchanged with oxygen at the surface of the tank. So at the surface of the tank, the CO2 gets diffused in the water and usually stays the top layer of the water. So that's why we say make sure you have proper flow in your tank to get those CO2 molecules running around your tank. But how much CO2 does get diffused from the atmospheres into a tank? Now that depends on two factors. The first factor is pressure. How much pressure is outside of the water? How much pressure is pushing the molecules into the water itself? The more pressure there is, the more molecules are going to get pushed into the water. The other factor is temperature. Okay, the warmer it is, the more molecules wants to leave the water and get dissipated into air. So for an example, let's imagine a bottle or a can of soda. Now a can of soda is filled with a bunch of junk, obviously, and what makes it really bubbly is the CO2. What we do is inject and force CO2 into that bottle or into that can and then seal it, right? And then you'll notice that when you open a bottle, you hear that sound coming from the bottle itself or the can. That's the CO2 being released into the air. Now, once that seal is broken, the CO2 starts rising in from the liquid and then gets dissipated in the air and then leaves. That's why after a period of time, your soda gets flat. Now, same thing with temperature. I'll give you a really good example of temperature is when you boil water. When you boil water, what happens? If you leave it on the stove long enough, there'll be no more water left and you get a burned pot. Same concept. When you heat up water, it excites the molecules, and the more the molecules wants to just leave the water and gets dissipated into the air. Same concept there with temperature. Now, we artificially put CO2 into the tank when we use a CO2 setup. Basically, we're just giving a lot more CO2 available in the water than usually naturally necessary. This allows a lot of CO2 for plants to thrive on, but also risks us suffocating our fish and livestock. So in the middle of the line here, we have something called passive CO2 or passive diffusion of CO2. Basically, what we're going to do is use those concepts and create a little area where it only contains pure CO2, and then naturally the CO2 gets diffused in the water because, one, you're creating a little pressure chamber that pushes the CO2 into the water. So that's a lot better than just naturally doing it. Second, it's pure CO2. There's no mixture of oxygen and nitrogen or whatever in that bottle. It's just CO2. So when people ask me, does it work? I go, yeah, sure, it works. It just works better than naturally CO2 diffusing your tank, but it doesn't work as well as you pushing CO2 in your tank with a pressurized system. So one way to do this is using a plastic bottle, a plastic soda bottle. Just put it in your tank, you know, submerge it, fill it up with water, and then turn it upside down, and then add the CO2 to the bottle itself, and just let it fill up with CO2. You're gonna have to refill the bottle every day or every other 2 days, but that's basically how you do it on the cheap. The other way is to buy an actual CO2 bell. Now, there's a couple out there that I know that I've used. One's from the Fluval G20 system, the other is from the Insta CO2 package. It's CO2 from a can. We'll talk about that in a bit. And as well as there's some places out there, I haven't found many, but I found one at Greenleaf Aquarium that sell a glass CO2 bell, and it looks really cool. Either way, any of these methods will work for passive CO2. So once you have the CO2 bell, you're halfway there. Now you gotta figure out where you're gonna source the CO2. Okay, so let's go over a couple of options. First one is the regulator that comes with the Fluval 20G system. I like using this, but it connects only to a 16 gram CO2 cartridges that you would use for paintball or for inflating your bike tires. The other option is using CO2 in cans that you like press it down and just release CO2, and you can get those from the Insta brand. And the second option is to get something like this. This is like a Dr. Moss regular. It's like 20 bucks or something like that. And what you can do is you hook it up to 88 or 90 gram CO2 cartridges, and then you just release CO2 from that little regulator into the bottle or into the CO2 bell. And the second option is to use a do-it-yourself CO2 setup, and I made a video about that before, but you just use this setup to put CO2 into the CO2 bell and then shut it off until you need to fill up the CO2 bell again. Now, what I recommend is if you want to get started on passive CO2, it's great for smaller tanks. Any tanks below 20 gallon works really well. I think above that, it gets a little wonky. All right, and you'll need a bigger bell with more surface area and stuff for the CO2 to diffuse into the water. But for smaller tanks, it works decently, and it will work, okay? So my suggestion is to get a kit, and these kits you can get on Amazon. I have affiliate links in the description below. Just to be transparent, I get a kickback from any guys clicking that link and buying stuff from Amazon, okay? Just to get that out of the way. Now, there's a couple of things that you need to know if you're going to go this route. Sometimes when you set up a CO2 bell and then you release the CO2 into the bottle or bell itself, and it gets diffused, it usually diffuses all the way, but there are times where you still have like what looks like CO2 left over, but it's not diffusing. That is probably not CO2. It's most likely oxygen, O2, because of the mixture in the tank, sometimes O2 will get into that canister itself, because it's all part of the diffusing system. That's just how it works. So that happens. All you do is just empty the CO2 bell and then just refill it and then fill it up with CO2. And of course, I have that video on the do-it-yourself CO2 setup as well as the Fluval 20G. So check those videos out here. And remember, hit that subscribe button if not subscribed, and that like button if this video helped you out in any way. I will see you in the next video. I love you guys.